Hello and welcome for a new Unity FT Designer video tutorial. My name is Michael and I'm working for Electronic Assembly's development team.
Today's tutorial is designed to give an overview of the possibilities for using loops in the Unity FT series. Three different options are presented in this tutorial: for loops, do while loops, and while loops. The macroscript language of the Unity FT series is compared to C code. First, I would like to start with a for loop. Let's start with a closer look to the equivalent C code. Our loop should be performed 10 times. Within the loop, we want to be able to execute several lines of code. On the left side, we can still see the C code. On the right side is a flowchart with the commands of the Unity FT series. In the following, we want to discuss a flowchart. The difference between C code and the method realized in the macroscript language is that in our case, the for loop is always executed at least one time. If this is not desired, you must prevent it with an if query in advance. There's also a tutorial for if statements available. We start with the first command, VRI. This sets the value of the register R0 to 0. The register R0 will be our loop variable. The for loop is based on jumps within macros. At the end of the loop, we have to jump back to the beginning if not all loop cycles have been performed yet. Use the MFM command to set a marker. A maximum of 100 markers can be set. A marker can also occur several times in the macro. The next lines contain all commands to be executed within the for loop. Now we have to jump back to the beginning of the for loop. For this purpose, we use a jump command MFJ, macro file jump. The first parameter specifies the jump condition. The second, the jump destination. We want that the loop is executed 10 times. In advance, we have set the register R0 as a control variable. In the condition, we therefore check whether the value is less than 10. At the same time, we increase the control variable by 1. Since we already run through the loop one time, we have to increment the register. Previously, we set a jump marker with the ID 1. We select this as our jump target. The register value R0 is 1. The jumped condition R0 is smaller than 10 is therefore fulfilled. We jump back to marker 1. Now we assume that we have already run through the loop 9 times. The register value R1 is by now 9. We walk through all the commands inside the loop for a last time. Now we come back to our jump condition. This time it is not fulfilled. Because of the increment, the register R0 is now 10 and thus not smaller than 10. We have now reached the end of the loop. This shows a direct comparison of C code and macro language. The difference between both is that in the macroscript language, the for loop is performed at least one time. This turns a post-increment of the loop variable in the C code into a pre-increment in the macro language. Using an example, I would like to discuss the for loop in the Unity FT Designer. A text should show the value of the loop variable. For this purpose, a text was placed and the type was changed to a formatted text. Within the loop, we only have to adjust the value for the formatted text. The loop should be started when the button is pressed. A macro with the name start loop has already been created and linked to the button's press event. Now we want to program the for loop in the macro. As discussed, we first set the register value of our control variable to 0 and place a marker for our return target. To change the value of the formatted text, we use the SFC command. We want to output the content of our control variable. In order to see the changes, we add a pause of a half a second. The XXW command should only be used at development time for debugging purpose, because the whole program is interrupted. Finally, there's a jump condition. We use the MFJ command as just discussed. Let's have a look to the result in the simulator. I have set -1 as initial value for the text. If we start the for loop with a button, we see that the text increases by 1 with each loop passes until 10 loops have been executed. First, we discuss the for loop, which has a fixed number of loop cycles. Now, we would like to have a look at the do while loop. The loop should be executed until the register R1 is no longer less than 10. Again, let's first discuss this example using a flowchart. Basically, the required code in the MacroScript language is almost the same as for the for loop. This time we assume that the register value R1 is 7. As before, we first set a jump marker. This is followed by the command lines to be processed within the loop. The do while loop also uses the MFJ jump command. We have to jump back to the beginning of the loop if our condition R1 is less than 10 is fulfilled. In our example, this is true and we jump back to the marker with the ID 1. Now we assume that the register value R1 changes to 14. Again, we work through all the commands inside the loop. Now we come back to our jump condition. This time the jump condition is no longer fulfilled because the register value is greater than 10. We have now reached the end of the loop. The structure of the do while loop is identical to the for loop. In this case, the condition R1 should be less than 10 is equal to the C code. Let's take a closer look to the do while loop in an example. For this, we use the same as before. Instead of displaying the number of loop cycles as text, we now want to toggle an output pin. Therefore, I deleted the text and defined port pin 1 as output in the screen initialization. The loop should start when the start loop button is pressed. Therefore, we use the same macro as before. First, we place a jump marker. To toggle a port pin, we use a HBW command. To see the pin flashing, we want to wait half a second. At the end, there is a jump condition. As long as the register value R1 is smaller than 10, the port pin should toggle. Let's start the simulator again. The register value R1 is 0 at the beginning. When I press a button, the jump condition is fulfilled and the port pin starts to toggle. If I now change the register to a value greater or equal to 10, the do while loop is no longer executed and the port pin stops changing its state. The two previous loops have been executed at least one time. The last loop we will handle is a while loop. The loop should only be performed if the register value R1 is less than 10. Again, let's have a look at the flowchart first. Compared to the two previous loops, there is not such a simple solution for the while loop. There are several ways to implement such a loop. In the following, I will present one. This method is based on the do while loop, which is marked in the flowchart. Before that loop, you have to check if it is allowed to be executed at all. Let's go through the diagram step by step. We assume the register R1 has a value 7. For checking the condition, we use the command mfc, macro file call, at the beginning. In general, it does the same as the mfj command. The difference is that you can also jump back again. We will use this later. The register R1 is 7, and the condition that the value should be smaller than 10 is fulfilled. We therefore jump to the marker with the ID 1. Now we can execute the loop. We execute the designed lines of code within the loop. We are now inside the well-known do while loop. The jump condition with the target marker 1 follows again. We use the same condition as for the MFC command. The register value has not changed and the condition is thus fulfilled. We jump back to marker 1. Now we assume that the register has changed to 14. We again walk through all the commands inside the loop. Now we come back to our jump condition. This time the condition is no longer fulfilled because the register value is greater than 10. With the command mfr macro file return, we get back to our first command mfc. To avoid rerunning the loop, we have to exit the macro with the command mfe macro file exit. We have now reached the end of the loop. The comparison of C code and macro script language shows very clearly how the while loop works. It consists of two blocks. On the one hand, the already known do while loop on the bottom and the additional jump condition on the top. The disadvantage is that the condition occurs twice. You always have to remember to update it in both jump conditions. I would also like to take a closer look at this function with the help of an example. The while loop is based on the routine of the do while loop. We therefore want to use the existing example of the do while loop as a base. We just need to add the additional jump command mfc at the beginning. If the condition is not fulfilled, we have to exit the macro so that the loop is no longer executed. For this purpose, we use the mfe command. At the end of our already known do while loop, we have to add the return command mfr. Finally, let's take a look to the result in the simulator. The behavior is similar to the do while loop. When I press a button, the jump condition is fulfilled and the port pin starts to toggle. If I now change the register to a value greater or equal to 10, the while loop is no longer executed and the port pin stops changing its state. The simulator supports additionally debug possibilities. Therefore, let's take a look to this more complex function in the debugger. We start the loop again by pressing the button. The debugger stops at the first line in the macro start loop. We now perform individual steps in the macro. We start with the mfc command. We change the register R1 to 0. So the condition is fulfilled and we jump to marker 1. If we execute the command hbw, we see that the port pin toggles. We reach the second jump command. This condition is also true and we jump back to marker 1. We are now in the do while loop. This is executed until the condition R1 is less than 10 is no longer fulfilled. We now change the register value to 20. The condition is no longer fulfilled and we reach the mfr command. We now jump back to our mfc command. To stop the while loop, the macro is now terminated with the mfe command. We have learned three different loops, for, do while and while loop. The first two are simple in structure and easy to implement. For the while loop, there is no such simple solution. There are several possibilities of realization. Also, with the help of a previous if query, you could realize such a while loop.
I hope you enjoyed today's UnityFT video tutorial. Maybe you have time and play around a little bit with our sample projects and enjoy our other tutorials.